I'm still nervous about that return to normal.
Once I get full immunity, like, what is it safe to do exactly?
I'm still nervous about possibly carrying the virus and giving it to someone unvaccinated.
And meanwhile, we're hearing
more.
We're
talking with science journalist Wendy Zukerman, host of the hit podcast Science Versus. Takes a closer look at what's just opinion, what's BS, and what's the truth.
The latest episode tackles the confusion around COVID-19. Good morning. Thanks for being with us.
Good morning. Thanks for having me.
So, what is the. Your idea is that you are going to separate what circulates out there and gets all this life and becomes what people think is fact from what is actually scientific fact. Is that true?
That's exactly what we do. Yeah, we've been going for about 5 years and tackling all sorts of things from the seemingly silly, like, you know, ketogenic diet or weird pet foods. But obviously with the coronavirus, the big things that we've been needing to tackle are misconceptions around the vaccine, around how scary the virus is, around, you name it, you know, immune boosting products that people are trying instead of getting vaccinated. So it's been a full-time job.
But let's start with COVID. The one I've heard most recently is this impact on fertility and or pregnancies. Can you address that one?
Absolutely. In terms of the vaccine, I mean, I should just say we get sent daily. I mean, even from scientists, I get sent these often Facebook messages around, you know, what if, could the vaccine be doing this? Could the vaccine be doing that? The idea that the vaccine can affect future fertility, it's funny. This is not a myth that is unique to the coronavirus vaccine. Specialists in this space say, I hear this all the time related to so many vaccines, and there is no evidence for it. Now, in terms of the pregnancy question, this is an interesting one. So, you know, we have some data coming out. There's been a lot of pregnant women who have gotten the vaccine, and so far it's looking like it is really safe. You know, when they compare the outcomes of, you know, once the women have their babies and they look at, you know, miscarriage rates and things like that, it's totally in the normal range. So we have no evidence that this is harmful for pregnant women either. Having said that, we don't have as much research into pregnant women as we do into non-pregnant people, and so I can perfectly understand why someone who's pregnant might wait for a little more data to get the vaccine.
So
we don't have any evidence that it's harmful, and I'm hearing a lot of BS, as you put it, around these fears. So the idea that it can affect future fertility, I mean, there's really no evidence for that.
So Wendy, do you find that some people question when you find facts? You're a science journalist. Are you a doctor yourself? Or, I mean, because people question doctors, do they trust what you find through your research?
You know, it's such a good point, and I'm not. I studied science at university. Our like bread and butter is scientific papers. So we have this big team behind us. Some of them have got a PhD, but we speak to experts and we cite all of our research. And I think that's why we've developed sort of this audience that really trusts us, because we have our transcripts of our podcast available for everyone, and we cite absolutely everything that we say. So if you are curious about something that I'm saying and you're listening and going, I don't know if I trust this, you should absolutely get on the Science Versus website. And there's a transcript with, you know, more than 100 citations where we are quoting directly from scientists. And I think, you know, we've been doing that now for several years. And I think that's what people really trust, because we will get some people, you know, tweeting at us like, how do you know this? And, you know, why should I trust this? And we say, you know what, you read the studies yourself and you tell us what you think. And, you know, far and away, people are just like, thank you.
Well,
now I get it.
That's the thing. It takes a lot of work to have insight into some of these things that a lot of people don't want to do. And that's why Gwyneth Paltrow is able to sell all these ridiculous miracle cures and so forth, which we've made fun of on this show for a long time. Speak to one of those. A common one is like detox. I've got toxins in my body and I got to detox it. It's my understanding that this is complete BS.
Yeah, you know, you have organs in your body that can detox these things just fine. You know, the kidney and the liver do a really good job. Mm-hmm. You don't need to buy fancy teas. I think it's so funny. Every year, every month almost, something new comes out saying like, this is the product you need that's going to make you so healthy. And time again, the things that make you healthy, like we know them, your grandmother knows them. It's exercise, it's a healthy diet, it's things like that. You know, there's no shortcuts here. In fact, the only shortcut there is getting the vaccine.
Let's talk about over 5 years, you must have had tons of questions. Did you have one thing that you looked up that really surprised you? Like, wow, I guess this, give me an example of something that surprised you doing your research.
Yeah, you know, I actually feel like I am surprised more often than I think I should be. Like, I tend to assume that all new diets out there are gonna be rubbish. And I have been surprised at the fasting diet, for example. That actually had some really interesting research behind it, and research that is ongoing to suggest that it really could be beneficial for some things. And that was a real surprise. I've gotten my mom onto it. I'm still not.
So that's the one, Wendy, is that where you do the intermittent fasting, like you won't eat for 12 hours, and the research on that you say is good?
Yeah, that's right. So I know it's sort of fasting. It's like a millennial style fasting. You know, you're actually just often not eating for 13 hours. So you have a late breakfast and an early dinner. But there is some research. So for example, just early research, but that suggests that if you're going through, say, cancer, that it might help reduce the symptoms of chemotherapy. And sort of exciting things like that. You know, also in the diabetes space, some really interesting research. So I was personally very surprised about that one.
Well, the Science Versus podcast is available on Spotify. Wendy, thanks so much for joining us.
Thank you.
Thanks for having me.